Your higher self. Why are you not connected with your ultra self? To put the notion of who and what your higher self is to place yourself into perspective. Take away your name, because your name is not you. Neither is your physical body you. You are something else. You are a mighty, powerful being which is beyond time and space. You ultra self being is even above spirit self. Your real being is even above an energy being. What you really are, is pure light. And you are even beyond light. You are basically untainted mind. It as mind who wish to experience existence in form. Even in your physical self, you are imprisoned inside your own body and locked up in your own mind. When shall you be free? You actually yearn to be free. Your higher self yearns to be free. But before it can find freedom, it must go through the process of self-learning. That is why you find yourself here on Earth. I hope you would find my video presentation enhancing and meaningful. I'm sensitive to higher awareness and esoteric interpretation of reality. I'm in direct contact with spirit guides and guardian angels. And so can you. I have done a video clip on how to make direct contact with your guardian angels, even contact with your guardian angel. I do not do spirit readings. I merely answer questions related to the issue of reality, meaning and secret inner knowledge. I'm not important nor am I significant. I am merely a seeker of truth. And, I'm sharing my knowledge with you. I do not want to be paid, because asking payment makes the quest towards the ultimate objective null and void. Don't forget to click like as it helps to grow the channel. Firstly, as a point of departure, I will deliberate on my own empirical exposition of my understanding and observation of what and who the higher self really is, and what it is not. The quickest and easiest way to your higher own self is through your dreams. That is actually the basic first step. But before we discuss further on what and who your higher self is, let us view who and what are you really in your physical existence. How could you understand the Almighty, if you do not know who you really are? Firstly, you have to unlearn everything you have learned, because everything you know and everything you believe are actually false. Your physical self is the vehicle through which your higher self grows. Example, if you need to find the treasures inside a sunken ship deep in the ocean, then you have to get into a deep sea diving suit. Now, this physical body of yours is the deep diving suit through which you can find the treasures of life. What are the treasures of life? It is not gold, nor silver. It is something no money can buy. The treasures of the world have no meaning, for everything in this dense physical realm is not really real. It is an illusion. Much like the Matrix movie. Incidentally, there are those higher spirit beings working through certain writers, painters, and people of note to make their works timeless, to help grow humankind. People like Galil Gibran, William Shakespeare et al. When you get to the other side one day, after your worldly demise, then everything on earth would no longer matter. It would no more matter all your suffering, all those who harmed you and everything you aspired for, like flashy cars, beautiful house, a lot of money, for it holds no for real value when you come to the other side. In fact, it applies to all of us. What are the treasures which your higher self so much lingers for? The most dearest to your higher self is to learn the lessons of your own life, the journey of your own soul. This falls under soul contract. I have provided a link at the end of this video to my soul contract presentations, as well as other types of videos on the esoteric phenomena. I have also provided my email at the bottom if you want to communicate with me regarding the topics under discussion. Basically, your higher self wants to learn goodness. Your higher self represents the Almighty, known as God or the Source. Rumi, the Persian poet, has said, "God is the ocean and we are the drops." My own perspective, I found I am indeed many aspects in one. It is through soul traveling that I have gained much inner insight of what reality really is. Soul projection or astral projection is easy. You are already performing soul projection and soul travel whilst in deep sleep. The difference is, You have to train yourself through practice to become lucidly awake inside your dreams. I have also done presentations on astral travel and other related topics of esoteric interest. I have also provided a link to my online books on esoteric phenomena, which you can read free online or buy at a very low price.